If you've got one of these on your fairly new Bailey caravan, maybe a Unicorn or an Alicanto, you might be thinking to yourself, fantastic, I've got a connection that I can plug in an external TV input, maybe even a satellite dish. And that assumption would be wrong. If we take a closer look at our TV amplifier, we can see that we've got TV 1, 2 and 3, which means that we can connect 3 TVs here in the caravan. And in fact, that socket on the side of the caravan is a TV output, which allows us to watch TV in the awnings if we so wanted to. So how do we go about changing that from a TV output to a TV input? Because for us, at least, we would rather have a socket on the side of the caravan that we can plug into an on-site TV hookup point, or even better, plug in a satellite dish. Well, surprisingly, it's quite straightforward. There are two methods which I'm going to show you today. The first one, if you're only interested in ever hooking up to an on-site TV point where terrestrial TV is not very strong and your caravan antenna is not great. And then the second method, a little bit more work, but it allows you to connect a satellite dish to that point, and you can then watch satellite and normal terrestrial TV on your television. So to understand what's going on here in the caravan, let's have a look to see how this thing is wired up at the moment. First off, let's put the TV amplifier, the TV antenna, the radio, and then the TV outlets that are dotted around the caravan. We have one in the living room, one in the bedroom, and then one on the outside. As you can see, we can connect 3 separate TVs at the same time. We also have a radio on board too. This plugs into the radio socket, and that is split up for FM, AM, and DAB signals. Okay, so that's what we've got. Now we need to make a change so that we can plug in an on-site TV point into the side of our caravan. And it's extremely straightforward, and it costs just a few pounds and takes about 10 minutes to do. With the addition of this splitter to our caravan, we can reconfigure the wiring and transform the antenna outlet on the side of the caravan to an aerial input. So let's bring all the items up again, but this time we've removed the third TV from the outside, and now we add the splitter into the mix. Let's now wire everything up. First off, the onboard antenna is plugged into one half of the splitter, and the external socket is plugged into the other half. The splitter is then plugged into the aerial input on the TV amplifier. So let's wire everything else back up, which, to be honest with you, was exactly the same as it was before. And there we go, the job is complete. The great thing about this project is it uses existing cabling, all except for the fly leads that connect the splitter to the amplifier. And for making the fly leads, I really recommend purchasing this kit of crimp F-type connectors, cable cutters, and crimping tool. It's currently under 13 quid at the time of recording, and it makes reliable connections every time. I've placed a link to this and all the other parts that you need for this project in the description down below. For cable, I'm using satellite cable, and this cable I had left over from other projects, but I've put a link to some good cable down below as well. Right, enough waffle, let's actually do this. First up, I disconnect the cable which is plugged into TV 3 and the cable that's plugged into the antenna 2. Now the antenna cable is a bit tight, so I have to take my time and use two hands here to unscrew it, but eventually it came free. Next, I plug the cable from the outside socket onto the splitter, add the onboard antenna to the second input, and then finally, I make a short fly lead to connect the splitter to the TV amplifier. One half screws onto the splitter, and the other straight into the TV amp. And there we go, that is it. So we've got our TV input coming in here. It's then being split with this one as well, and then both signals are going into the amplifier. So that's it, really straightforward. Couple of points I want to mention about this though. If you do plug the caravan in to an on-site TV hookup, one thing I would strongly recommend is just turn the amplifier off. It doesn't need to run. You don't need to amplify an already amplified signal. You probably will distort some TV reception, you might lose a few channels, and most importantly, you're probably going to overrun the receiver in your TVs. You don't need to do it. Now, if you want to plug in your satellite dish into the caravan, this modification that we've just done won't work, and there's a very simple reason for that. But to really understand what the problem is, let's take a closer look at the splitter we've just used here in the caravan. In the previous method, I used this splitter. If we look closely at the writing, you can see it has written on it power pass on both sides. This means that any voltages that are present are passed between the inputs and the output. This is ideal for an amplified signal from our TV post outside. This isn't, however, ideal when we add in a satellite dish. A satellite dish needs between 13 and 18 volts to work. This is sent to the LNB on the dish from the satellite receiver indoors. If we plug a satellite dish into the current configuration, at best, the TV amp will block the power and it won't work, and at worst, it could overload the TV inputs on our TV sets. So, to get around this, we use what's known as a diplexer. It looks almost identical to the splitter we used before, but look closely at the text on the box. It has power pass on one side only, and it clearly marks the SAT and the TV inputs. A diplexer mixes both the signals into one, and at the other end, if we use a second diplexer, we can split that mixed feed back into their separate signals, without transferring any voltages to our TV antenna. So how does this help us? Well, let's add all our onboard equipment once again, but this time let's add the satellite dish too. Because we're using a satellite signal, we need to change the living room socket to have a satellite and a TV outlet. So let's change that right now. Let's add a pair of diplexers, one of which will be next to the TV amp, the second will be situated next to the TV socket in the living room. So to begin, we'll wire up the TV antenna, the radio, and the bedroom TV. For the purposes of this diagram, by the way, I'm going to be using TV too, just to keep all my scribbles neat for you to understand. In reality, you'll see me changing TV1 in the caravan in just a minute. So let's plug our satellite dish into the side of the caravan. Then this cable plugs into one of the diplexers on the satellite input side. The other input connects to the TV1 out of the amplifier, and the output is connected to the cable that goes to the TV socket. So over at the TV end, the TV and the SAT inputs are connected via two fly leads to the socket faceplate. And then that's it. The TV antenna and the satellite receiver can plug into this new faceplate, and the job is done. Now, this may sound a complex job, but actually it isn't. In fact, what you can see here is all the kit we need to make this work. So let's get cracking. Just like before, unplug the cable that feeds the external socket. In this instance, it's TV3. Then remove the cable from TV1 as well. Whilst I have this cable in my hand, I'll attach the first diplexer to this cable. And this is the output socket from here. Next, I'll add the cable from the satellite dish to the SAT input, and then connect the TV amp to the TV1 input using a small fly lead. Okay, so basically we've got our satellite coming in here from external, that will also run a TV external as well. We've got our onboard TV antenna coming in here as well, and then all of this is then being mixed together in this little box and then sent off to TV1. Now we need to go and do the second part of the install. Over at the TV point, the first task is to remove the surround, and this simply unclips in place, and you shouldn't need any tools regardless of its design. Once removed, unscrew the TV socket, and then making sure the power is off, I usually use my thumb in the 12-volt socket to pull it straight out. Doing so removes the socket and exposes the cabling. Now we need to complete two jobs here. We need to transfer the TV and the satellite sockets, but also connect up the 12-volt outlet too. So remove the coax connector and then the 12-volt power cables. Remember that white is ground, yellow is positive in this instance. And once I've added the wires to the faceplate, I momentarily switch on the power to the caravan and use a 12-volt USB socket that lights up to prove that it's all working and wired correctly. The next task is to connect the second diplexer, and it's important to check that the satellite output is wired to the satellite socket on the faceplate and not the wrong way around. Don't ask me how I know this. Once all of it is connected, it's then time to plug in the existing coax, and that's it, the job is now complete. But before I close everything up, I'm going to give everything a bit of a test. Outside, I have this QuickSat QS65 dish on the floor. In its current location, it can just about see the satellite in the sky over the roof lines of the caravans and the motorhomes here in storage. If I were to move this back a bit, I'd have an excellent signal, but this is just a test and I can't really block the storage yard. So once aligned, I plug the dish into the side of the caravan and perform a signal test on the TV. Which, as you can see, is great quality, just not a great signal. This is due to the satellite dish position outside. Good, so let's test it all out. Okay, so this is using the antenna, and these are the programs that it's found. So as you can see, these are all working beautifully fine. I think it even found some HD channels as well. Let's just double check that. If we go back here, if we go to 101. And yes, BBC One West HD. There we go, that seems to work lovely. So the antenna side of things is working as it did. Let's now check to see what happens when we switch over to satellite. Program Manager, if we go over to Filters, we change this now to Satellite, like so. It will now bring up all of the satellite signals as well. And I know BBC One doesn't work, I know that for sure, but just because of the lashed up installation outside. But I know BBC Two works. There we go. I know this because I was testing it earlier on. So let's go back. And there we go. We can see we're on FreeSat. So we've got satellite signals and TV signals both coming into this one TV using one cable. I've got to put that back together again. I've also got to clean up that mess. But there we go. And it's all coming through there. But there is a bit of a problem with this installation. It's not so much a problem, more of a limitation. And the limitation is this, and I don't know if you've clocked it already, but it's only affecting one TV. The way that we've combined the signals at this end, split them out the other end, it's not affecting the second TV at all. So that means that the TV in the bedroom in our caravan will only ever be able to use the onboard TV antenna. Now for us, that's not so much of a problem because we'll just watch TV here. If there is no onboard TV signal, we'll just watch TV here and then go to bed, and that'll be that. But of course, we've got a smart TV in the bedroom anyway, if we do want to watch anything whilst we're snuggled up. But that's something to bear in mind. Now, there may be more complex diplexes and splitters available. I haven't been able to find the ones that I think would do the job, but if I do, then I'll make a follow-up video to this one and I'll show you how we can then install that into a second TV point. But there we go. This cost me about £30 to do. The most expensive part was the face outlet there in the caravan. All the other pieces I think were about £8. I know I bought the tools to do the F-type connections, but you know what? That's a tool that I'll keep now forever because it's so very, very handy. And that's it. I hope this project has been useful for you. Certainly gives you an idea on how you can make pretty good upgrades in your TV antenna experience, especially if you've got a Bailey like this one, maybe a unicorn, where it looks like you've got a TV input, but actually it's a TV output. But there we go. That's it from me. Many thanks for watching. And if you do like this video, let me know. And I'll see you in the next upload. Please do hit the subscribe button, hit the notification icon if you can do all that. I'll see you next week. Many thanks for watching, everybody. Take care. Bye-bye.